What did Pickles win for winning the dog surfing competition? Watch out behind you! Pickles! Pickles! Come to safety!
Welcome to Watch Mojo, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 craziest live TV fails of 2021.
It's live TV, the joys of live television.
For this list, we'll be looking at the times 2021 proved that live TV only gives you one chance to get it right. Any memorable blunders that we missed? Regale us in the comments. Number 10, Rocket Giggles.
Rockets everywhere this morning while outdoing his fellow billionaires in the race to space. Amazon boss Jeff Bezos will blast into orbit next month.
Do you know what they call that?
A rocket.
They call it Blue Origin.
We all get the giggles every now and then, but usually it doesn't happen when we're live on air. In July 2021, former Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos made headlines for going into space briefly aboard the Blue Origin NS-16 rocket. The internet got its fair share of comedic jabs in at the event, but few were as amused as presenters Carl Stefanovic and Alison Langdon on Australia's Today Show when the proposed launch was announced.
Does that look a little odd to you? It's just me. Joining us now for more.
Maybe it was the music from 2001 A Space Odyssey, or maybe it was just the image of the rocket itself. But Stefanovic and Langdon couldn't seem to complete the segment without cracking up.
Hey, they laughed at Louis Armstrong when he said he was going to go to the moon. Now he's up there laughing at them.
Number 9. Dog steals microphone. We've probably seen too many instances of people deliberately interrupting news broadcasts, but what about man's best friend? In April 2021, reporter Nadezhda Serezhkina was giving a live weather update in Moscow when a golden retriever suddenly entered the shot and relieved her of her microphone. Serezhkina then chased down the dog, said to be named Martin, and completed the broadcast with the slightly damaged mic. Martin too returned for the shot, as Serezhkina made sure to make the best of a funny situation. Looks like Martin just wanted to play fetch and found the quickest way to get someone's attention. Number 8. Back to you, Satan. Don't you just hate it when you're doing a news broadcast and the devil literally gets in the details? Well, that happened in August 2021, sorta, when the Australian Broadcasting Company accidentally inserted the wrong clip into their feed. During an otherwise serious story about police canines, the footage suddenly went from shots of masked individuals to a satanic ritual.
Due to the stabbing of a police dog during an arrest in Brisbane last year.
Hail Satan.
Now, before you start thinking darker forces were at play, it should be mentioned the inserted footage seems to come from another segment done by 7 News earlier in the year, which covered the Satanic Temple lobbying for Satanism to be taught in schools.
The Education Minister Grace Grace has slammed the request as a stunt, saying Satanism has never been taught in Queensland schools and never will be on her watch.
Well, Grace, we've got news for you. It's going to happen on your watch.
Whatever the case, kudos to ABC presenter Yvonne Young for continuing as if nothing had happened. Number 7. Sean Hannity vaping. In recent years, vaping has become an increasingly more popular alternative to traditional cigarettes, and apparently one of its converts includes Fox News political commentator Sean Hannity. During Hannity's eponymous program, the host was seemingly unaware that the commercial break had ended and could be seen puffing on the device. Hannity soon became wise to the situation and quickly disposed of the item before uttering a meek, uh-oh.
Uh-oh. Now our villain of the day.
Of course, Hannity then began the next segment, but that didn't stop his colleague, Laura Ingraham, from poking fun at him as soon as he turned it back over to her. Hannity shrugged it off by saying, quote, "Enjoy it, everybody, at my expense. We are, Sean, we are." Number 6, a show called You.
To the politics and all those woke storylines in so many shows today.
One of the most captivating thriller TV shows on right now has to be You. No, not You, You, the Netflix show called You.
Well, hello there. Who are you?
We're sure this kind of confusion has sprouted up numerous times, but never so infamously than on Fox News in November 2021.
You know, I was watching an episode of You where measles came up.
Wait. When did I mention measles?
I don't know. It was on you.
During a segment, Raymond Arroyo attempts to make reference to the show before being cut off by a perplexed Laura Ingram.
It was an episode of a show, Laura.
Well, what's it called?
You.
What is
you.
He talking about?
It's called you.
I've never done a show on measles. I just completely gave up.
The two go on for quite some time, but many were skeptical as to the authenticity of it. U-star Penn Badgley was quick to call it out, and Arroyo himself later admitted the bit was planned. If you're gonna do a use on first routine, you should probably be named either Abbott or Costello.
What are you talking
Never mind.
About?
I'm moving on to Adele. I can't explain this to
What's
you.
What's he talking about?
Number 5, meteorologist multiplication.
Ooh, that's funky. What is going? Ooh. I don't really know what's going on.
We've gotten a plethora of green screen related blunders during weather reports on news broadcasts. And if this is any indication, they'll never not be funny. In May of 2021, meteorologist Jennifer McDermott attempted to do a weather segment for the Minnesota area when suddenly she and the graphics started to multiply.
You guys want one Jennifer or two Jennifers? This is
we're having a technical meltdown.
There being nothing she could do, McDermott rolls with it, making sure the viewers are at least entertained as the tech crew scrambles to correct the mistake.
Can you lead that train off the screen?
Temperature is 58 degrees. I have no idea what that was.
Even once the program gets back on track, McDermott and her colleagues simply can't contain themselves. And you know what? Neither can we.
Next week, back into the sunshine. But every single day, temperature is above average.
Whatever button you pushed, don't do it again.
I don't know what happened.
Number 4, I gotta pee.
Time now for one more thing.
I gotta pee, I gotta pee.
You're on the air.
You know, we all gotta go to the bathroom every once in a while, but we usually don't sing about it. When the Fox News show The Five came back from commercial break in March of 2021, apparently not all five of them were actually aware of this fact. Greg Gutfeld, oblivious, suddenly breaks out into song to let us know what's at the forefront of his mind.
Ah, you can't beat
Greg,
me!
Greg, maybe you could use that cat's litter box if you have to pee so badly.
How did you know I had to pee? Yeah.
Gosh. All right.
You said it on the air. No.
I did?
Yeah. All right.
Everyone heard it.
His co-hosts futilely tried to get his attention before carrying on without him. Of course, they made sure to rib Gutfeld afterward, who even took to Twitter later to assure us that his bathroom excursion was indeed successful.
I believe he said he had to go pee.
Number 3, McCarthy completes Trump.
We're all about to see something for the first time.
January 2021 was a controversial month for former US President Donald Trump, between the raid on the Capitol building to handing the office over to Joe Biden to his second impeachment. But if there was any comedic relief to be had, it came from MSNBC. Brian Williams cues up a supposed clip of Trump meeting with House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy. But that's not what we get.
We'll watch it and react on the other side.
I love you. You complete me.
As most anyone will tell you, that's not Donald Trump and Kevin McCarthy, but rather Tom Cruise and Renee Zellweger from the movie Jerry Maguire. The famous clip lines up so perfectly with what preceded it, and guests Baratunde Thurston and Bill Kristol can't help but crack smiles.
That is, obviously we have rolled the wrong clip and we were sold a bill of goods here. I thought this was going to be of the McCarthy and Trump meeting, and someone's going to be, of course, in big trouble.
Number 2, Kitler. Oof, where to begin with this one? You would think that a news segment about cute kitties couldn't possibly be controversial, but never underestimate the twisted imaginations of pet owners. During her weekly Saturday segment called Catter Day, in which a fan-submitted cat picture is shown, Kansas City meteorologist Alina Lee spotlighted a white cat with a mustache-looking patch of black named Kitler.
So we've got our Catter Day night forecast for you now, where we are featuring
Kitler here, thanks to Debbie Alexander. And I think Kitler kind of looks like Charlie Chaplin here, so I don't know, maybe we're going to call him Charlie Jr.
Though Lee compares the cat to that of Charlie Chaplin, the unfortunate inspiration for the name is more than clear.
I did make a mistake during our Caturday segment. I used a submitted photo of a cat with an inappropriate name. I don't want to use the name here, but I never intended to hurt or offend anyone by using that picture. That was actually just given to me.
Lee later apologized for the oversight in a later broadcast, but we'd like to hear from whoever got their joke aired at her expense.
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications.
Number 1, Tour de France pileup. This was the live TV blunder heard round the world. Though the Tour de France has had its fair share of controversy over the years due to contestants, this time it was a spectator that caused a scene. On the very opening stage of the race, an unnamed woman leaned out onto the track to show off a handmade sign to TV cameras. However, her back was to the action, and German cyclist Tony Martin was the first to catch her off guard.
It is chaos. There is riders, bodies, staff everywhere.
This naturally caused a huge pileup, one of the worst ever, forcing two riders to withdraw from the competition and eight others to be treated for injury. The woman, after turning herself in some days later, has since faced lawsuits.
And it was all the fault, clearly, of a spectator with a banner in front of the riders, looking, as always they often do, at the camera rather than the race coming from the other direction. And once one rider went, they completely fell.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from WatchMojo, and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.